And sometimes it's the little things that make a big difference. Barbara Zabel, who runs our internal communications group, showed up in my office one day with a little gizmo that she was putting on the top of my computer screen, and it was a webcam. And it wasn't so Barbara and I could Skype, it was so I could deliver quick, simple messages to the entire employee base on a moment's notice. And it just goes to show you, you don't need a big production crew, you don't need slick videos, nice editing, all this, a fancy soundtrack in order to communicate transparently with people. I think the simplicity of my weekly videos underscores the value that we place on transparency. It's just me and the camera, and I found these to be very effective, and I recommend a similar strategy for any CEO who has an agenda to be transparent and inspire trust with their employee base. Every Monday morning, I come in, the first thing I do is I sit down in front of this little webcam, and I send a message out to the team about what's really important for the week ahead and what I'm counting on them to deliver, and asking for their feedback. Now, let me step back for a minute from our case study and make a larger point. I've focused my comments thus far on the importance of transparency, and it is important. But I want to emphasize is that transparency can't be a strategy of convenience. We can't pull the curtain back when things are going well, only to pull it shut when we've made a mistake or things are headed in the wrong direction. One of the things that I work hardest on, and I know my team works hardest on, is building credibility for me, for my team, for the company. And I think there's no bigger threat to credibility than a lack of transparency. You can miss targets, you can introduce a new product that doesn't sell, you can hire the wrong person. In fact, all of these things happen to just about every company at some time or another. But it's the way that you deal with these negative issues that really determines your credibility. Now, that access to information has put other people in control of your reputation. And as we all know, a reputation can take years to build and only 140 characters to lose in this day and age. And that's a scary thought for just about anybody, which is why the communications function has never been so important. Now, of course, social media has changed the game when it comes to transparency and building trust. Whether CEOs like it or not, we're living in a business and media environment where it's now expected that brands will communicate with all of their stakeholders in an open and transparent manner, but also that stakeholders have visibility to almost all of the company's communications, whether you like it or not. How many times have you seen an organization send out an internal memo only to have it reported in the traditional media or found online? It happens every day. So, why wouldn't you be doing everything you can to build up trust from your stakeholders that will carry over to help you navigate the bumps that inevitably you're going to face in the road? The fact of the matter is, there is no good excuse for why a CEO shouldn't embrace transparency and run a transparent company. It is the only way to go, and certainly that's my belief, and it's why I'm here with you today. And with all the technology that we've got at our disposal, it's just incredibly easy to do. We can reach all stakeholders with one single message across a myriad of platforms and media, and from there, they can do a lot of work for us. They become our guiding coalition, they spread our message, and they get our agenda out there and ultimately activate their networks, which is incredibly powerful. And more than ever, we have the ability to have eyes and ears in conversations we otherwise wouldn't have had. People have always been talking about our brands, but now we actually get to listen in. We get to interact, we get to make our case, we get tremendous feedback, and we do it in real time. We can react faster, but importantly, we can do it as a cohesive unit. But it all begins with a tight partnership between the C-suite and the corporate communications team. That is essential, that is foundational to all of this.